I'm sitting at the Ngulia Lodge overlooking the Ngulia Rhino Sanctuary. This used to be the home of 10,000 rhinos 50 years ago. Today, what you see behind me is a reserve, a closed area with a fence, hosting about 100 rhinos. The situation has been even worse, so 20 years ago the rhino were more or less extinct from this area. Today the population is growing thanks to the hard work of Kenya Wildlife Service overlooking the population. So if you compare Ngulia in size, it's about the same size as Linköping City. It's located in a larger national park, also a fenced area of the size of Skåne. It's called Tsavo West. Adjacent to Tsavo West is Tsavo East and other national parks in Tanzania and Kenya. And together, the size of these connected national parks is about the same size as Belgium. Also comparable to the more well-known Kruger National Park in South Africa. So Kenya Wildlife Service has about 22 rangers in duty inside Ngulia at every time. In total, there are about 60 rangers located here. These rangers are working in pairs. So one pair of rangers are responsible for one small part of Ngulia. So there are about 11 different blocks. So they patrol the blocks at least once, normally twice every day. And during the patrol, they keep track of rhino tracks like footprints, droppings, resting places, browsing marks, etc., etc. That's for the conservation work to monitor the well-being of the rhinos. But they also look for signs of intrusion because poaching has become a major threat to the rhino population, and that is how it started 50 years ago. Today, Ngulia is doing better. There haven't been so many poaching incidents in the last 5 years. Actually, since we started this project in 2014, there has been only one poaching incident where two rhinos were killed. So that's the good news. But the bad news is that still in Africa you can see carcasses like this, rotten rhinos, where you can see that it's a poaching incident because the horns are cut off from the skull. So Project Ngulia aims at providing technology to assist the rangers in their daily work. And so far we have provided them with a smartphone with an app, basically digitizing their daily workflow. So before they used paper and pen and their walkie-talkies to report what they saw in the field during their patrols. Today they have the app that works like a sports tracker or runkeeper, so they can log how they patrol, so they cover their blocks as good as they can. As soon as they see something, they open the app, they click on a few menu items, and you can file a report in a few seconds. You can also take a picture of the footprint or dropping or whatever you see. And of course, if you happen to be lucky to see a rhino, you take a picture of it and you have a direct sighting reported into the system. So the app reports to a cloud solution we have provided. And there's a dashboard for the offices. They can, in real time, check what the rangers are doing and what they have observed. And they can get summaries and statistics of everything that has happened there. We have had this system in use now for 4 years, more or less. So there is today a lot of statistics available for how the rangers usually patrol and cover the blocks and what they see and report, etc. But this is just the beginning. So we have provided a digital way to do the reports, but we will also provide what we call super eyes and super ears to the rangers. And that is done by sensor technology. So we will use everything from sensor networks to surveillance cameras, radar systems and drones in the end. That's the final goal of the project, to have all kind of sensor modalities assisting the rangers to keep track of both the rhinos for their well-being and for detecting intruders and possible poachers. There is a lot of solutions in the Western world today for protecting critical infrastructure, for instance, airports, nuclear power plants, etc. These are quite expensive and they require special technicians and maintenance people. We have a few catchwords for the project that aims at a bottom-up approach. So we start in a small scale and we gradually increase the technology level step by step, and no giant leaps. The solutions have to be cost effective, and thus we are looking for innovative solutions using off-the-shelf products, more or less. The smartphone is and will be the platform for the whole system. To make this happen, we have a public-private partnership where everyone helps as good as they can. So we have in Kenya a partnership with Airtel, one of the biggest operators. They assist with the communication skills. So they have tuned the base station, so we have a good internet connection in the Ngulia sanctuary. And we also have SIM cards, free SIM cards with the data bundles topped up every month. Local ownership is important, so we won't spend so much time there ourselves, but we have Kenyan people taking care of the training in the field. And training is the key word here. I mean, it requires a lot of training to introduce new digital tools to this application area. So again, what we have today is a flexible report system in form of an app. And we have a dashboard for the officers. And that includes a lot of challenges in itself, like data security, which is very important here, of course. Communication in the savannah is not obvious that it will exist. Different positioning solutions for rangers and also for detecting rhinos and poachers. Cloud service, databases, APIs, etc. During our work, we have also engaged in the local community. So we are working with the four schools in one of the poor cities surrounding the Tsavo West National Park. And we have assisting them with all kind of tools for gardening, for sports, for schoolwork, and arrange different community days where we invite the local community, parents, students, and also Kenya Wildlife Service to sit down together and discuss the problem with the wildlife in Kenya.